My gratitude on primary 5. This is our fourth lesson. But before I go further, I want to remind you about the activity that I said in the third lesson. So there are some questions that I said about tourism and also game reserves in Uganda. So make sure you go through the questions and even make sure you also receive the corrections. So today, we are going to look at the factors that promote tourism industry in Uganda. But before looking at the factors, we can still go through about the tourism. I said that tourism is the act of traveling for leisure. Then you see that we have two types of tourism. One, we talked of domestic tourism and also international tourism. Then we also went ahead and looked at examples of tourist attractions in Uganda. Examples of tourist attractions in Uganda, where we talked of beautiful sceneries. Another beautiful sceneries, we talked of the wild animals. Then we had climate, we had culture, etc. But there, we are going to look at the factors that can promote the tourism industry in Uganda. So if you look at these factors, how can we improve the tourism industry in Uganda? So we are looking at the factors that the government of Uganda can do in order to improve on the tourism industry. So the first one is having better accommodation. Having better accommodation facilities. So what can I give are the examples of the accommodation facilities? I.e. we can talk of the hotels and also have book the lodges. So if you look at the hotels and lodges, one, they provide food to tourists. Two, hotels and lodges provide shelter to tourists. So I've given two examples of the accommodation facilities. I said one, you have hotels, then the second one is lodges. So they can ask that how do hotels and lodges promote tourism? The first one should be that hotels and lodges provide food to tourists. Two, hotels and lodges provide shelter to tourists. Then we can look at the second factor, and that's improved the security. Improved the security. So when we talk of improved security, as we are receiving tourists from different countries, the tourists will need the security. So the government has provided security to tourists. Then we can also talk of better transport network. Better transport network. So this one is about roads. So the government should construct better roads, especially in the tourist centers or places that attract tourists. So these are some of the factors that can promote the tourism industry in Uganda. Now, after looking at the factors that can promote the tourism industry in Uganda, then we can look at the importance of tourism industry. Importance of the tourism industry. How do we benefit from the tourism industry? What are the contents of the tourism industry? How does the government of Uganda benefit from the tourism industry? One, tourism industry, VSA, market for local goods. Tourism industry gets market for local goods. My lovely children, you ever seen that tourists in Uganda buy some materials or some crafty materials that are made by the local people? So when they buy such items, they will be creating market for the local goods. Then two, tourism industry is a source of government revenue. is a source of government revenue. Tourism industry is a source of government revenue. So the government of Uganda is collecting money from this tourism sector. Like now, if you look at the game parks, they always get money from game parks. Look at the water bodies, they always charge some money, some little money from the tourist centers that we have in Uganda. So that money which is being collected is considered as a government revenue. Then you can also say that the tourism industry is a source. Tourism industry is a source of income. Source of income to people. Especially when you look at the game parks, we have the game wardens and game rangers. So if you look at those two groups of people, they have been employed in the game parks, so they are getting money. And when you look at the game parks are under the tourism industry. Then you can also add on, and we said that tourism industry has created, jobs to people. Or you can say, tourism industry is a source of jobs to people. Again, we can talk of the game rangers. We have game rangers in game parks and also have the game wardens. My dear children, you are looking at the importance of the tourism industry in Uganda. One is the tourism industry gets market for local goods. Two, the tourism industry is a source of government revenue. Or you can say, tourism industry provides foreign exchange, the government of Uganda. Then the next one, tourism is a source of income. We have many people in Uganda who have been employed in the tourism industry. Like I talked of the game rangers and also have the game wardens, especially the game parks. Then we have our last point, the tourism industry has created jobs to people. Again, we have the game rangers and also have the game wardens. When I talk of the game rangers, here we look at who are providing security in game parks. Then the game wardens, these are people who are looking after animals in game parks. So these are some of the importance of the tourism industry, the government of Uganda. Then after looking at the importance, we can also look at the problems. Problems facing the tourism industry in Uganda. Problems facing the tourism industry in Uganda. What can we give as the problems facing the tourism industry in Uganda? One, we can talk of poaching. So our first challenge is poaching. My dear children, what is poaching? Poaching is the killing of animals in game parks. Or you can say that poaching is the illegal hunting or the illegal killing of animals in game parks. Remember I said that if you look at game parks, in game parks they don't allow poaching. But maybe poaching can be done in game reserves. So our first challenge is about poaching. And I've said poaching is the illegal hunting of animals in game parks. So when you can kill some animals in a game park, it will be reducing on the number of animals. So poaching leads to animal extinction. Then we have our second challenge as poor accommodation facilities. So our second problem is about the poor accommodation facilities. So that when you look at the poor accommodation facilities, at the importance, look at the examples of and the factors that can promote the tourism industry. I gave you two examples of the accommodation facilities. So we have the lodges and also have hotels. So, in the case of poor accommodation facilities, then we shall be receiving less tourists from different countries. Then the third challenge can be about the insecurity. Insecurity in some parts of Uganda. Look at some places in Uganda where the country is not politically stable, people are having conflicts, people are ever demonstrating. So when we keep on rioting, we shall be reducing the number of tourists. Then we can also talk of outbreak of wildfire. Especially people who are coming out bush burning near the tourist attractions. Like now look at people who are living near forests. When you get out bush burning, you end up affecting the trees. Then we can also talk of poor transport network, or you can say poor roads. So we have poor transport network. And network should be one word. Poor transport network. Under poor transport network, we can look at the poor roads, especially in the tourist attractions. Now, after looking at the problems or the challenges facing the tourism industry, what can we give as the way forward? How can we control? How can we solve the above challenges? Like when you are talking of poaching, how can we control poaching? One is by enforcing strict laws against poaching. So we can enforce strict laws against poaching. Then still under poaching, we can also talk of sensitizing people about the dangers of poaching, especially those ones who are carrying out to poaching. Then the second problem is about poor accommodation facilities. How can we control? How can we solve? One is by having improved accommodation facilities, e.g. hotels, e.g. lodges. Then insecurity. When you talk of insecurity, like now you can look at the game parks. How can we control the problem of insecurity, especially in game parks? So the government should employ trusted game rangers. So you can talk of employing trusts. Then what else? The government should also provide security, especially in the tourist centers. Then we have another challenge of outbreak of wildfire. How can we control the problem of fire outbreaks? One is by discouraging people from bush burning, especially people who are living near the tourist centers. Then poor transport network, this one here can be solved by the government or through constructing better roads, especially in areas that attract or in areas we have very many tourists. So poor transport network can be controlled by constructing better roads. Then after looking at the problems and even the solutions, now lastly we can look at the ways. How can we control ways the government of Uganda, ways the government of Uganda can promote the tourism industry? How can we promote the tourism industry in Uganda? How can the government of Uganda promote the tourism industry? So we are looking at ways the government of Uganda can promote the tourism industry in Uganda. So the first one, we can talk of by constructing better accommodation facilities. My dear children of primary 5, look at the spelling of accommodation. ACCOMMODATION. So the first way is by constructing better accommodation facilities. And what can we give are the examples of the accommodation facilities? I talked of the hotels and also lodges. And the two is by constructing better rods. So the government of Uganda should construct better roads. Then what else? We can also talk of employing trusted game rangers. So the government of Uganda should employ trusted game rangers. People who don't allow poaching to be carried out, especially in game parks. So these are some of the ways the government of Uganda has to do in order to improve on the tourism industry. But at the end of my lesson, so I can go through briefly. We look at the factors that can promote tourism industry in Uganda. We talked of better accommodation facilities, improved security, better transport network. Then after looking at the factors, we also went ahead and looked at the importance of tourism industry. Where is the tourism industry? Yes, market for local goods. Tourism industry is a source of government revenue. Tourism industry is a source of income to people. Examples, we looked at the game rangers and the game wardens, especially the game parks. Then tourism industry is a source of jobs to people. Or you can say that tourism industry has created employment opportunities to people. E.g. the game rangers and game wardens. Then we also look at the problems facing the tourism industry in Uganda, where we talked of poaching, especially in game parks, poor accommodation facilities like lodges and hotels, insecurity, especially in places where people have the conflicts, where there are civil wars, and where people are demonstrating. We also have outbreak of war, wildfire, and this one is caused by bush burning. We also looked at poor transport network. Then the way the government of Uganda can improve on the tourism industry in Uganda. We talked of constructing better accommodation facilities, employing trusted game rangers. So my beloved children of primary 5, this has been our lesson 4, but before I end my lesson, I can talk about the questions that I've given you. So I've tried to set some questions that you are going to do. And make sure you also use the hard copy, the paper that you are getting from the school. You go through that work. Then when you go through, you'll be able to get some answers for the questions that we are ever sending for you.